Remarkable night it was at the Turin Stadium for Cristiano Ronaldo as he helped Juventus come back from 2-0 down from the first leg to qualify for the next stage of the UEFA Champions League. 3-0, their game ended yesterday Atletico Madrid, and we're all about Cristiano Ronaldo. What a game, what a moment it was for the man who knows the UEFA Champions League very well, the king of the UEFA Champions League, scoring a hat-trick for Juventus to make the next stage of the competition. That was not the only story last night in the Champions League. Manchester City smashed aside Schalke 04 by 7-0 to complete their two-legged tie, 10-2 on aggregate, to make the next stage of the competition. I'll show you highlights of how it all happened in those two matches. But here on the local scene, former Ghana FA Executive Committee member Kojo Fiano has been speaking on the work of the Normalization Committee. Now, Fiano says he would have loved to see the committee's work come to an end this month, but admits that is not possible and has no qualms of an extension of their mandate.
They begin an assignment to normalize Ghana football had gone into some challenges. And I believe that the employer is the right person to do the assessment. But as an industry player, I would want to say that I would have loved to see the work of the organization coming to an end at the end of March. But Ghana is not an airline on its own. We have seen normalization committees working for 2 years, some beyond that. I will only pray that they will not stay longer than necessary.
Would you welcome an extension of mandate?
I don't have that control over as to extension. FIFA has it. And I'm saying that Ghana is not a landline to say that we could work within the 6 months. So if FIFA, they have the right to ask for extension, we cannot begrudge them. The only thing I want to say is that whatever time they will be given, we should all ensure that they work within the confines of the extension. That we will not wake up again at the end of that tenure to say that we are asking for additional. Looking at it from the flip side, definitely yes, we would have loved Ghana football to come to normalcy by now. Because you know what football means to Ghanaians. So Ghana, a football loving, where we pride ourselves as football being the our passion. To be without football for this time, I think that we're feeling the heat, and we want football to resume as quickly as possible.
So from Kojo Fiano's comments on the normalization committee, let's move to the Black Stars. And former Black Stars defender Sam Johnson has defended Coach Kwesi Appiah's 24-man squad for Ghana's final Africa Cup of Nations qualifier with Kenya this month. Now, according to him, Coach Appiah's decision to invite players who haven't been consistent for their clubs will not affect the team going into the Kenya game.
What is happening now is happening before. So it's not now that somebody will say, okay, somebody is playing regular. And they are not calling him, they are calling. It's not now. It started a long time ago. So he knows the kind of information he's playing. So why not? If we give him assignment, we want him to go to the AFCON, to bring the AFCON. Let him do it. If he can't do it, what happened? He'll go away. That's all. So at the moment, whatever he's calling, I have to support him because he's my man. He's my countryman. He's your countryman. Fine, everybody will have his own opinions, which is normal. But we don't have to oppose on him that you should do this, you should do that, you should do that. At the end of the day, he is the coach. He knows the kind of information he's going to play. So,
all right, let's do some athletics. And Ghana Athletics Association executive member Dr. Mark Dradosi thinks some Ghanaian athletes are capable of qualifying under the new IWF standard qualification for track and field for the 2020 Olympic Games to be staged in Tokyo. Now, for the sprint, which has more Ghanaians participating, the new standard qualifying time is 10.05 seconds for men and 11.15 seconds for women for 100 meters. Well, the athlete will be required to clock at least 20.24 seconds for men and 22.08 seconds for women for the 200 meter race. And the qualification time for 400 meter races will be 44.909 seconds for men and 51.35 seconds for women. And many fear Ghana may not get representatives in these events due to the new standard. But Dr. Dradosi thinks otherwise, although he admits it will be tough.
We are capable of qualifying some people, but I have to admit that locally or in Ghana, Ghana-based athletes will find it a little difficult because the type of the environment that exists outside is not what exists here for most of our. I talk about systems in place in terms of administration, academic infrastructure, sporting, everything. We are a little disadvantaged. Even coaching, the knowledge of coaches, there is quite a big difference. So Ghanaian athletes are going to find it a little difficult, but I still believe that, you know, a few of them will still make it. You know, the standards look scary. Let me use the word scary. Yes, when if you're in track and field and you see a male athlete has to run 10.05 to qualify in the 100 meters, long jump, 8.15 meters. That looks scary for a lot of people, but it's achievable. It can be done.